Hands up if you've ever been caught in the corner of a party, stuck in an awkward conversation, wishing you could just eject a seat out there. Yep, me too. Just the other night, in fact. But sadly, and despite what you might have heard, I am not James Bond. So I was stuck in that corner until I made that age-old, time for the loo excuse. Bond's Aston Martin DB5 in Goldfinger contains probably the most famous ejector seat in film history. And apparently, it really worked. Well, in one car. The film actually features two Aston Martins. One was there to look beautiful and to be driven on roads, while the second gimmick car was fitted with an old ejector seat from a fighter plane triggered by compressed air. So did it work? Well, many years later, two master's students in the Department of Physics and Astronomy at the University of Leicester published a paper on the force exerted by the Goldfinger ejector seat. They came to the conclusion that when ejecting someone from an Aston Martin DB5, the force and pressure required is 1,930 newtons or 8,870 pascals, although they did assume the thing was ejected via a hydraulic piston. They compared this to pressures and forces inside a typical piston engine and concluded that James Bond's getup was feasible. And this is backed up by Top Gear and Mythbusters too. When Top Gear tried it, they kind of freestyled a bit. They only had a budget of 300 quidish and they threw in a ball drop, bullet shield, paint guns and a rocket. Mythbusters got back to basics though. They copied the 1960s prop makers and used compressed air to shoot the seat. And again, they found it plausible that a stunt could work in real life. I should say, don't try this at home. No, really. Just this year, a teenager broke his back after trying out a friend's homemade ejector seat powered by a car airbag. So how did the early airplane ejector seats work? Well, what do you know? They were also powered by compressed air. Today, though, ejector seats are more likely to be powered by computers and explosives. Oh, and the pros tend to call them ejection seats. There's all sorts of ways to activate your ejection seat in a fighter plane. Some are via the traditional handle, others are triggered by pulling down a protective face covering, but you'll have to forget the old gear stick ejector button, I'm afraid. However you do it though, the second you trigger ejection, an electric pulse triggers the hatch or roof above you to be jettisoned. Sensors all around the chair measure speed and altitude, and a central processing unit determines how the seat should blow. Then a rocket, an explosive power catapult, or both together kick you and your seat up and out. Don't panic though, some fighter jet chairs have rocket stabilizing systems that fire to stop the chair spinning. Some. The whole sequence takes less than 1/10 of a second. Then a few seconds after ejecting, the altitude sensor automatically deploys your main parachute. With the seatbelt ejected, the chair drops away. Cheers, gravity. A survival kit is often included, dangling below you, but there's no more support from the seat. 4 seconds after bailing, you're on your own, alone, and likely terrified. In the 1940s, only about 50% of ejections were successful. Today, that's up to 90%. But ejecting is still a dangerous maneuver. If you leave a plane traveling at close to the speed of sound, then you can have up to 20 Gs of force acting on your body. That's 20 times Earth's gravity. In 1995, Captain Brian Udell had to escape from his F-15, traveling at near Mach 1, the speed of sound. The blood vessels in his face burst, his head inflated to the size of a watermelon, and his legs were so badly injured that one leg, cover your ears if you're a little bit squeamish, was only held on by his vein, artery, and skin. Still, he lived, all thanks to the quick action of his ejection seat. Martin Baker, the British company who are one of the world's leading manufacturers of ejection seats, even run an exclusive club for their pilots who've used one of their ejection seats. Send them a story, they send you a tie, which I'm really hoping has like an F-15 at the bottom and you sat in an ejected seat right at the top. The most unexpected ejection has to be what happened to an unnamed South African gentleman in 2009. He was a civilian and he was only there because he'd been invited on a joyride with the Silver Falcons air display team. Somehow he managed to pull the emergency eject lever by accident and, much to his surprise, found himself shot out into thin air on his rocket-powered chair. Whoops. Luckily for him, the canopy opened and the parachute deployed automatically. He survived the incident unscathed, although presumably somewhat stunned. Ejection seats, never a dull moment. Everyone, we are in for a little bit of a treat here at BritLab HQ. I am joined by the rather awesome host of our sister channel, Earth Unplugged, Miss Maddie Moat.
Hello, everybody.